Yes, it's the fire of the lion. Fireflies is which have gone through a long, long, and we're so very grateful to Smith's for the year. And there's one of the most up-to-date parts of that story, with the bang, bay on, bay off container on the back there. Very much, there was a forerunner of these, known as the Jessica Dinosaur, which is the same sort of equipment as so much AEC base at the time. Okay. Yes, it's the fire of the lion. What staff of the local builders are represented there by the Ford Pens. The little tip of the lion following that. Now, the first ball I was spotted. And this is the very first followers that came over here, and it's not really entailed in the beginning of the owner's rather revolutionary emotion transforming the late 60s, early 1970s. And once again, Volvo's really had the edge on motor transport. And that was certainly the whole thing. Oh, wow. Well, a good bit of sound riding on there. I guess it's coming to see a lot of Jersey sheriffs in that beautiful cold track. Lovely example there of the vintage J3. A vehicle much loved by the itinerant community in this country. And then here's an ERS, and as I mentioned earlier, the ERS, paint and phones, Edward Phones. And that's not surprising because they could grow by an American company, General Motors, and this is very, very much the American stepchild to that style. Now back to Bedford, from the late 1930s through to the mid 1950s, with the M series there, the long wheelbase. Green drop car that we see down there. Now you may have noticed there's one or two showground vehicles on the parade here. Well, these are the Scabbers. And they were very, very popular because of their, actually they're quite a phenomenal gun with the consumer diesel, regardless of the vehicle at the time. There is one man over there. Running. And it's coming through from the very, very end of the 30s, interrupted by wartime production. Completely different style of army origin. They're Atkinson, now a British manufacturer. This Atkinson disappeared in Drew Detail, as you can see. And you can see this one's done its time in Showground. This isn't a fake livery on here. You get the chance when you get up close to it, you'll see that the fairway on this thing, I believe, it still carries a solid fare. No guy. And this is the guy who has the six-cylinder diesel on the length of the bonnet. Although many of these guys are produced with the five-cylinder Gardner. Sell these spare parts of our engines very, very easily because the same spares fit in single cylinder gardeners right up to 8-cylinder gardeners. Compatibility and standardisation. Now this is just a modern idea of production. Gardeners were doing it years and years ago. Now if you look at that front line of the Milton, which is down there, the front line itself is very, very spectacular in many ways, the quality, variety and the ranges of its shows. If we start at the end, right at the far end from the commentary box, and we'll drop down, we've got the AEC, this is this vehicle hang out of production, sizing of cab here, and You can see it on your, if you're looking forward to that. So it's very much like this. There's a lot of things to it. I've got a feeling that was probably right on the end of the phone story almost. The phone story of the...